You're probably going to be like us and wonder, is the Samsung Galaxy S9 worth it? Because it looks an awful lot like the Galaxy S8. Well, we've been testing it for a little while and the answer is just about enough. It is a lot more expensive and it does have a few more features. So let's dig in and see exactly why it might be worth your money. Right, so one of the big problems we had with the Samsung Galaxy S8 was the fingerprint scanner, where it was right next to the camera in a really hard to reach place. Now, Samsung's changed that with the Galaxy S9, put it right on the back just under the camera, and it's much easier to hit. On top of that, the iris scanning in the Galaxy S8 just wasn't good enough, neither was the facial recognition. But put the two together, and Samsung's got a new thing called Intelligent Scan. And this is actually a much, much more accurate version where it uses the same kind of thing as Apple's Face ID to scan your face, or your irises if it can see them, and unlock the phone for you. It's actually very quick and very useful, so you combine that with a fingerprint scanner and it's very easy to get into the Galaxy S9. If you've seen any adverts for the Samsung Galaxy S9, you'll know that AR emoji is a big thing, and it's really a response to Apple's Animoji. Now, the way this works is it takes a front-facing camera picture of you and creates a fun little cartoon emoji. Sounds nice. And yeah, for a couple of minutes it is. You know, you can make silly faces, it can do fun things, and you've got a lot of GIFs that you can share with your friends. But quite quickly these get boring and people keep wondering why you keep sending vague-looking pictures of yourself in little fun movie formats. On top of that, you've got the fact that you can record videos using it, but the front-facing camera just isn't strong enough to do that, because what happens is it kind of captures your face, but it gets loads of little weird flickers, and it just looks a bit odd, rather than being a fun feature like Animoji, which really captures the nuances of your face. When you pick up the Samsung Galaxy S9, you could be forgiven for thinking it's actually just the Samsung Galaxy S8, because it is very similar looking, except for the fact the fingerprint scanner has been moved on the back. There is a small change under the skin though, because the aluminium that's been used is a little bit more robust, so there's less twisting. The glass is a little bit thinner, but still stronger. In terms of the way this actually feels in the hand, it's very similar, but you are going to get a more robust phone and there's less need for a case. In our first few weeks of testing with it, we did find there were very few scratches, although the fingerprints are all over the back of this because the glass is an absolute fingerprint magnet. Right, let's move on to the screen. Now, this is a 5.8-inch Super AMOLED affair from Samsung, as you'd expect, and it's very similar to last year. We've got the same resolution, the same color quality. In fact, everything is very similar, except for the fact that it's 20% brighter. Now, this is quite useful when it comes to direct sunlight, because once again, it's very easy to see things like if you're watching a movie, when you're sitting outside, and you know, smartphones 5 years ago couldn't even see anything at all, so to be able to watch a movie is very impressive. Now, the downside to this is it comes at the cost of battery life, and the auto brightness will automatically go straight up into this really high brightness situation, so you have to be careful if you're going to be using it too much outdoors. Now, the big change Samsung has brought to the Galaxy S9 is to the camera, and that's because it's got a new dual aperture sensor on the back. This means you've got an f-stop of 1.5 for incredibly good low light photography, and you've got an f-stop of 2.4, which means you can take brighter outdoor scenes that just look that much more crisper. There's actually a mechanical shutter in here which changes the size of the sensor itself, much like an iris, and that means that you can actually see what's going on much more easily depending on the scenario you're in. Now, the problem we've got is that while yes, you can take good low light photos, the actual quality and crispness of the brighter light ones isn't that good. The colour is the main issue, because you're getting some quite overexposed almost pictures because of the fact that the camera seems to be trying to work out how much light is coming in. These are great photos, don't get us wrong, but we were expecting just a little bit more in terms of it being an amazing camera that just blows our socks off. The Google Pixel 2 is sometimes a little bit better when it comes to taking pictures, and we expected a little bit more from Samsung. Now, that said, there are a load of really good modes on this phone. You've got panorama, you've got pro mode, food. All of these actually do make a good difference for the phone itself. So if you're gonna experiment with the modes and try different things, every single one of them is actually quite useful. So on the front of the phone, you've got an 8-megapixel sensor, which takes some pretty good selfies. It's very similar to last year, but those modes were actually quite good. For instance, this year you've got selfie focus, which is kind of like Apple's portrait mode, not as strong perhaps because it doesn't have the true depth camera that can take the background blur for you, but the results are pretty good. You've also got wide selfie, where you can take a group shot more easily when you're twisting the phone left and right, and it does yield some quite good results. Of course, you also have the AR emoji mode that we talked about earlier, and while that is fun, it's just not amazing. So the most disappointing thing about the Samsung Galaxy S9 is the battery. Yes, it's got the same 3000 mAh battery pack inside like the Galaxy S8, but usually Samsung's good at improving the efficiency, so it makes the software more lean, it's got a better processor inside, and we thought, you know what, this is going to last longer. It doesn't seem to be that way. We actually get to about 9 p.m. each day when things are getting dicey, so we were constantly charging mid-afternoon, but just to make sure that we can make it through the evening. Now, the good news is you can charge wirelessly with both Qi and PMA standards, and also fast charging is enabled too, so if you've got a charger around, this isn't really a problem. But you shouldn't have to do that. The Samsung Galaxy S9 is a flagship smartphone in 2018, and we expected battery life to be at least a whole day. So how to start the Samsung Galaxy S9 best? Well, I'd say it's just fine. It does fix some of the big issues from the Galaxy S8, namely the biometrics and actually getting into the phone itself. Now, the key question is, with the Galaxy S8 still on the market, is this worth the extra money? And Well, it depends how much that biometric issue really bothers you, because if you could reach the fingerprint scanner on the back or you didn't really care about security, the Galaxy S8 is a fine buy. You've got a really good camera, battery life is very similar, the screen and design both also quite nice. The Galaxy S9 does bring some key upgrades, namely that low light camera is very, very impressive, and you've got the biometric issue that's been fixed. So if you are worried about certain elements of the Galaxy S8 and you want just the best on the market from Samsung, the Galaxy S9 is it. So in short, this could still well be the phone of 2018, but its rivals have a really good chance to catch up. And of course, for our full review, loads of great camera samples, all that stuff, please head over to techradar.com and check it out right there. And we'll see you again soon for more phone reviews just like this.